All right. Another thing I did to the view while I had the front bumper off, I installed this DIY intake, cold air intake. I wanted to go with the ones that were for sale, the K&N, but it stopped here, and I wanted to run it out into the bumper to get as cool of air as possible. So this is a true cold air intake. I had seen one kit that added to the factory one that came down. It's no longer for sale, and the K&N was just too expensive to take it and then add even more to it. So I just bought a cheap kit off of eBay, and it's garbage. It's not even worth linking, guys. It was trash. But it basically got me the couplers I needed, and I had to put in a different grommet to run the air temperature sensor. I believe that's what that is there. Out of the original factory air box. But yeah, once I put in the new grommet and fit him in, that worked perfect. This is a Spectre piece. I believe that's how you say it, that had the three ports on it. So I just utilized one of the ports. The kit also came with one, but those holes were bad, real bad, real bad. I wasn't even comfortable using them, so I went with the Spectre one that I bought separate. But basically, I bought it for the bends, this bend, and then you had a straight, another straight up here, sorry. So you had a straight, a bend, a short little straight, and this straight, and a bend, another bend. So I think it was probably a 90-degree bend and a 45-degree bend. That worked out perfect to make everything line up like I had intended. I bought that U-shape rubber coupler off of eBay. I actually had to splice about an inch or so off the end, cut an inch or so off the end, sorry. And then I actually sectioned this and expanded it. I just have a thin little piece of metal in here to basically expand it. And I took this piece of rubber and stuck it in here just so that it would all be nice and smooth rubber. And then I had that clamp that I had gotten from Home Depot that had the twin hose clamps on the end. So I utilized it. I've got to go and get some nicer clamps. This particular kit came with these, I don't even know what to call them. Crappy little things with rubber band O-rings, and two of them were busted, and so I ended up ordering these a bunch of red 3-inch couplers. Used three of them to make it work. I bought this piece off of Amazon for a decent price. It's the nicest one of the bunch. And last but not least, I had to drill a hole in the rubber ducting, and I used a coupler off of, let me get it. This is a piece off an old 80s GM car. I had taken it off and upgraded to something nicer. So what I did is I cut off here. This section is actually installed in the rubber hose. This piece fit over that factory line perfectly and fits super snug. So I'm assuming that's the PCV system for, you know, blowback and all that good stuff. The only thing I have yet to do is I've got to come up with something that's actually attractive to go here. But seeing as how the car was down while I was putting everything together, I couldn't drive over to Home Depot and come up with something nicer. I'm going to put my head together with my friend and see what we can come up with. But for now, I mean, it's solid, it's steady. I added this split foam that you can get at Home Depot around the hole here where the original air silencer went through so that there'd be no scratching. And you see everything's pretty solid. You know, I actually layered it up a little bit on the bottom to keep everything. Still got a little bit of wiggle, but I think it's going to hold good and steady. I think I kind of overdid the fastening, but I wanted to be sure I wouldn't rub here, that there wouldn't be any rubbing there. You can see I kind of wrapped that strap through where the initial bumper went. Reutilized this with a spacer to just kind of hold it. I'll have to polish this back out later, but whatever. I did it for function, not for the super eye-pleasing nature of it. I wanted it to look nice. And I know some people say, oh, heat soak because you use metal tubing. Guys, it's aluminum stuff, so hopefully the heat transfer will be minimal back and forth. I mean, you win some, you lose some. Yeah, if I was made of money, I could come up with something better, but this was all on a budget. I think I did all this, worst case, $150, a lot cheaper than the $399 K&N system. So, yeah. Anyway, I may go over this in more detail in the future, but I wanted to at least preliminarily show you guys the system and how everything was routed prior to putting the bumper back on. I can always go back over prices and parts and everything else. And this was a, before you hammer me on this was a takeoff filter that came on the Del Sol. I just reused it. I may upgrade to something better in the future, but I wasn't even sure this was going to work. So there you go. Started the truck up. No issues, no lights, no problems. I just need to put it back together and test drive it. The exhaust does sound a little bit, more full. Now, it's got a little bit more oomph to it. I don't know that it really made any difference, but yeah. So there you go. DIY home brew cold air intake. It's not the prettiest. It's not the greatest, but it'll work. All right, y'all, take care. Oh, and 2004 Saturn. All the sensors should be the same on others, but I'm not going to guarantee that. So, but worked on the 04. Take care, y'all.